Hey, how's it going, guys? In this video, I want to give you guys a quick update on the WebdriverIO Sync mode. Now, before we jump into the Sync mode, it is important for you to understand how the asynchronous mode works in WebdriverIO. So let's talk about that. The WebdriverIO runs asynchronous commands to interact with the browser. And these asynchronous commands are such as your click, interacting with any element, or it could be such as adding a text on an input field. Now, in JavaScript, you can use async await to handle asynchronous behavior. But there are some downsides to this. So for those that are not familiar with async await or in general asynchronous programming, they will find this code a bit confusing. Also, using async await for each command is actually quite verbose as well. Since in WebdriverIO, majority of the commands that you will be using are going to be asynchronous. And to actually handle that asynchronous behavior, you're going to have to use async await. Let's take a look at an example. If you notice over here, I have a describe block and then I have a test over here. And the one thing to notice here is we're using async over here in our function, which is in our it block. And after that, I'm accessing an element, which is my body. And to access that body, I have to use the await. And if I don't use that, it will not be able to actually get the access to that body element. So I'm using async to create my asynchronous function and I'm using await to actually resolve this element. So once this element is actually resolved, I get access to it over here, and then I'm able to go ahead and click on it. Now let's take a look at this line. Here I'm trying to pause the execution, and for that I also have to use await as well. Now the way this await works is, it is possible to do it this way. However, if you're trying to do it directly like this, where you're trying to chain functions, where you're doing await body.click, this will actually not work. Because you need to first get the body element, which is over here what we are doing, and once you get the body element, then you need to do await click on that as well. So instead, you have to do a code similar to this. We're doing await, and then we're doing await body and dot click. So let's say if you're not from the JavaScript background, this will be really confusing code for you. So to handle this problem, what WebdriverIO did is they came up with WebdriverIO sync mode. So let's talk about what is that sync mode. So they created a WebdriverIO sync plugin, and this was created specifically to run WebdriverIO commands synchronously. Now the way this works is it uses node fibers to make those commands synchronous. Now you don't need to be familiar with what node fibers is. Essentially what it's trying to do is each and every command it's trying to resolve it on its own so that you don't have to use the async await. So what are the advantages of this? So like I mentioned, it got rid of all the async awaits. So everything that we were doing before, adding an async function and then awaiting the element and then awaiting again and clicking on that, it gets rid of all of that. And because of that, our tests are looking a lot more easier to read and understand. And that was one of the main reasons WebdriverIO got so popular, because it was extremely beginner friendly. So now let's take a look at that code. So instead of doing it this way, where we're doing async await and then doing await again over here, what they did was they got rid of all those async await. So as you can see, we are not using the async function here, as well as we are not using await keyword over here as well. So using this WebdriverIO sync plugin, it is automatically knowing that, okay, we're trying to access this URL, and then we're clicking on the, or basically we're trying to expect this browser and to have this title. So here we don't have to mention that, okay, you have to use async await for each line. So as you can see, WebdriverIO sync mode really made code a lot more readable and easier to understand for everyone. And that was one of the main reasons I liked using WebdriverIO as well. However, there are a few things that changed. So now let's talk about that. So WebdriverIO discontinued sync mode. Now, if you're not familiar with this change, if you go ahead just now and install the latest version of WebdriverIO, which is version 7 and above, you're going to notice that you will not have in the configuration the option to install the sync package. And this is the same sync plugin that we talked about in our previous slide. Now, at the time of this recording, they got rid of that configuration so that people don't use that sync mode anymore. Now, why is that? Let's take a look at this. So WebdriverIO actually put out this warning on their website, which said that the sync mode will not be supported anymore starting from Node version 16 due to some changes in Chromium. And they also say that if you start a project with WebdriverIO, they recommend to not use sync mode anymore. And the community is actually working on transitioning from sync mode to async mode. So essentially what happened is there were some breaking changes in Chromium. And because of that, we will not be able to use the WebdriverIO sync plugin anymore. So they put out this warning to say that, okay, you need to stop using the sync mode. Instead, you need to switch to using async mode instead. Now, obviously, making this transition is not going to be as easy. If you're using sync mode for a while, switching it directly to async mode is going to be quite painful. So they looked into a couple of options over here. And some of the options that they explored was, first figuring it out if there's a workaround. And obviously there was no straightforward way where you can find a workaround and continue to use that sync mode. And the next option was to ship WebdriverIO with a custom version of Node.js that will support using Node Fibers. And Node Fibers is what you need to actually use WebdriverIO sync mode. But once again, having a custom version of Node.js and maintaining that is a huge hassle. So that doesn't seem like a good option either. The next was basically dynamically rewriting the code into a sync mode. But obviously, just if you're rewriting the entire code, that's also not easy to do. So basically, the one of the options that they looked into was accepting the fact that WebdriverIO is going to be asynchronous from now on. So what that means, as they suggested over here, any new projects that you're going to be starting, you should not be using the sync mode. Instead, you should start using asynchronous mode. So if you notice here, from WebdriverIO V8, they said they will not be supporting WDIU sync package anymore. Now to help out the community, they're going to write a code mod which will help user transition from synchronous mode to asynchronous mode. But what the code mod will do is, if you have a code or basically existing test framework which is using sync mode, if you run that code mod, it will transition or move all of that code into async await. Now this hasn't been built yet, this is still being in planned, but this is something that they're planning to do right now. And if you want to read more about it, you can go to the WebdriverIO website, and on the sync mode, you can click on this link, read more that in this RFC, where you can read about all the latest changes that are happening right now. Now let's take a look at how the code might look like from WebdriverIO V8. So over here, I've copied the thread that Christian Berman added. The way the change he's implementing is, you will continue to use async await the way you're using it today. But now the new additional functionality that you're going to have is, you can actually chain elements. If you notice here, he's chaining foo with bar and then doing another command here, get, and then doing another command on get tag name. Today with WebdriverIO v7, this is actually not possible. Instead, what you're going to have to do is you will do await foo on this, then you're going to do await bar on this, then you're going to do await get. So basically for each and every individual command, you're going to have to add awaits. And that's one of the reasons you see multiple awaits when you're working with WebdriverIO current async await code. But with this change, you will be able to actually chain multiple of these commands. And because of that, your code will look a lot more simpler and easier to read. Now keep in mind that this is something that he's trying to implement right now. This might change later on. It's not something that is confirmed yet. So you should still wait till WebdriverIO V8 and the official documentation that will come out to see what exactly will happen when this code will get implemented. But I still wanted to give you a quick heads up to let you guys know what are some of the possible changes that might happen in WebdriverIO V8. Now there's still a way where you can go ahead and use the sync mode. So how can you do that? Well, the very first thing you need to do is check your package.json to see if the WebdriverIO sync package is actually installed there or not. If you're using any version below version 8, most likely either you will have that WebdriverIO sync package already installed or it would not be installed. So if it is installed, you can continue to use the sync mode as usual and you can follow along with my WebdriverIO sync mode video series. However, if it is not installed, then you can install this package by doing npm install at WebdriverIO sync. But one thing to keep in mind is that WebdriverIO will continue the support for the sync mode until they decide to drop the support for Node 15. Because starting Node version 16, WebdriverIO sync package will not be supported anymore. So my personal advice would be is that ideally you should start using async mode for your new projects to avoid doing any kind of migrations in the future. So for example, if you decide to implement WebdriverIO in your project, instead of using the sync mode, you should go ahead and simply start using the async mode. Because that way, whenever the new code that will come out in version 8, it will be an easy transition for you. But if you go ahead and start creating all of the tests in sync mode, then you're going to have to do a bigger transition from sync mode to the async mode. Because at the end, the sync mode is going to get discontinued. If not now, maybe in a couple of years, it will. So your best bet would be is to actually use async mode for your new WebdriverIO projects. Now, for those of you that are going to be watching my WebdriverIO tutorial series on YouTube, over there, I was using version 6 and I was using the sync mode. If you want to follow along exactly the same way, you can simply do that for now by installing this WebdriverIO sync mode. But by the time you're watching this video, if the version 8 has already been released, I would advise you to actually use async await instead. And I will go ahead and create some more videos on async await so that you guys are familiar with how to use async await with WebdriverIO. Only thing I'm waiting for right now is the new update that will come out, which is going to be for WebdriverIO V8. Because if I create videos right now, there might be some changes that might come out in V8, which might not be suitable anymore. So I'm just waiting for that change to come out. Once it has come out, I will create some videos so that it's easier for you to understand how to use WebdriverIO Async mode. All right, that's it for this video, guys. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. And if you have any questions, you can put that in the comments below and I will try my best to answer all of them. Also, as an additional update, I have started a private Facebook community, which is accessible to anyone that's on my mailing list. So in this community, I will be sharing all the videos and blog posts that I put out, as well as it will be a platform where we can interact with each other on a more frequent basis and talk about all things related to testing and automation. If you want access to it, subscribe to my mailing list and I will have the link for that in the description below. Now, if you don't use Facebook, you can follow my page on LinkedIn instead, where I will be sharing similar updates as well. That's all for now, guys. I will see you all in the next one.